Hey, you boys of 345, we're here with a new online game that I'm going to be playing called Dungeons & Dragons and Neverwinter. I found this invite to this in my email box, my inbox, because I once played another game by the people that made this. I'm assuming it was made by the same people, which is called Dungeons & Dragons Online. Anyway, this game is in open beta, I believe. It's made by Perfect World, and I know nothing about it. I have not yet played this game. I've watched about 10 minutes of another person's video, and all I know is that there's a cutscene that I'll probably be turning up my volume for. Like, if you can see, I can turn up my volume like this. I'll probably turn it up when I get to that cutscene so you guys can listen to it. I'm not sure if you guys can hear what I'm saying right now. I'm assuming you can. It's not very loud, but I've had a bad run-in with the background music being louder than my voice. Anyway, this is going to be kind of a little let's all see what's going on kind of video. So I'm not sure how long it'll be. Anyway, new character. Beholder, I guess. I'm sorry if this is really loud. I mean, I hope it's not.
Thank you.
Huh. I'm gonna turn down my volume now. Truthfully, I'm not sure how loud that is for you guys. All I know is that was very soft for me. I could barely hear anything. Truthfully, I didn't want to risk it being actually a lot louder for you guys, so I thought, yeah, if nobody can hear it, it's not gonna be the end of the world. If you want to hear it, just go and get this game yourself. It doesn't cost anything, at least as far as I know. I got it for free via an email. I'll put a link to it in the description. I'm probably not gonna do any, like, other videos for this. This is probably just gonna be an introduction video so that all of us can take a look at it, and I'll probably just play it on my own. Okay, so we got a couple of classes. We got half-orc, human, dwarf, elf, half-elf, halfling, and tiefling. Tieflings are like demonic kind of things. Elves are good with magic. Half-elves are kind of good with magic and kind of like humans, I think. I am not up to date with my knowing of everything Dungeons and Dragons. I want to be more up to date. I have a couple of books right there on my shelf. Like, I think I have the 4.0 books. I also have like the 3.5 books or something. I don't know which one it is, which version it is, but I have two different versions. So let's see, Wood Elf. Wild and free, Wood Elves guard their forest to the lands using stealth and deadly arrows from the trees. They build their home in close harmony with the forest, so perfectly joined that travelers often fail to notice that they have entered the Wood Elf community until it is too late. Half Elf. Descended from elves and humans, half elves are a vital race in which the best features of elves and humans often appear. Oh yeah. Let's see, elven accuracy. Increase your chance to critically strike by 1%. Ability scores gets 2 dex, 2 intelligence, 2 wisdom. Wild step, you have 10% resistance to affect and spell your movement. Albano. Grants +1 to a non-class ability score. 2 constitution, 2 charisma, and 2 wisdom. I like constitution. I think that's your health. Knack for success. You are just naturally better at many facets of life. Getting a plus 1% deflect, +1% critical severity, and a +1% gold find. Tiefling. Plagued by a dark and sinister heritage, tieflings walk through the shadows of their race's past, savoring the darkness or trying to escape it. Tieflings are scattered through Faerun, littered geographically in the reminder of distant times when devils and demons exerted an active influence over the land. Bloodhunt, you deal an additional 5% damage to targets below half health. 2 charisma, 2 constitution, 2 intelligence. Infernal Wrath, whenever you are hit, you have a 10% chance to lower the power of the attacker by 5% for 5 seconds. Halflings are a small race known for their resourcefulness, quick wits, and steady nerves. They are nomadic folk who roam waterway and marshland. Though people travel farther to see more of what happens in the world than halflings. Nimble Reaction. Your small stature and quick movement grants 3% chance of deflecting coming attack. 2 dexterity, 2 charisma, or 2 constitution. Bold. Your fearless nature increases your resistance to crowd control effects by 10%. Half-Orc. Half-Orcs combine the best qualities of humans and orcs, meaning this is pretty much a powerhouse. Though some would argue that the good qualities of orcs are few and hard to find. From the orc blood, half-orcs inherit great physical strength and toughness. They are fierce warriors, fleet of foot, and hurt as they charge into battle. Fierce Assault, that your critical hits do an additional 5% damage. Get 2 dexterity, 2 con- and either 2 constitution or 2 strength. Switch charge, you gain a 10% bonus to run speed for 3 seconds when you enter combat. This effect would only occur once every 20 seconds. Dwarf. The glory of the ancient dwarven kingdom lies far in the past, yet these stout champions remain vigilant against the myriad of foes arrayed against them, claiming that they stepped fully formed from the heart of the world. Dwarves have much in common with the stone and steal their respect. Stand your ground, you have increased resistance to knock and repel effects. 2 constitution, 2 strength, or 2 wisdom. Cast Iron Stomach, you have increased damage resistance to damage over time effects. And Human. Of all the civilized races, humans are the most adaptable and diverse. Human settlements can be found almost anywhere, and human morals, customs, and interests vary greatly. Versatile Defense, increase your defense by 3%, 2 to any ability score, and you gain an additional heroic feat points at levels 10, 15, and 20. Then I'm gonna be a human. Male human. Okay. Continue. my character class. Okay, this one's coming soon. Trickster Rogue. The master of stealth and misdirection. Trickster Rogue maneuvers across the battlefield and strikes from the shadows with paired daggers. The Trickster Rogue dodges in and out of melee, inflicting massive damage on foes with a flurry of deadly blows. Yeah, stuff like this. There's no translation for stealth. There's bait and switch. I'm not gonna bother reading those. Very cleric, that's probably a cleric. Full wizard, highest powers of arcane energy to destruct, crush, and debilitate their foes. Uses really big weapons, and is usually better to defend everybody, I'm assuming. I kinda don't wanna have to read these again. Huh. Probably a trickster world though. The Trickster Rogue, my primary stat is Dexterity, secondary are Charisma and Strength. I'm not gonna be here. I'll be a great weapon fighter. Strength, Constitution, Dexterity. Yeah, I'll keep 2 Constitution. There we go. Not very much dexterity, but I do have a lot of strength and some pretty good charisma. I mean, constitution. This one. I've never been one to really customize my character all that much. Okay, I'm not gonna read these. I've been reading them because I'm not sure if you guys can see them, depending on how good the quality is. I have some pretty good quality for me. I'm not sure how well it'll be recorded. Let's see. Okay, Lady Luck, Royal Fury, God of Battle, Mistress of Beauty, Lord of Nature, Goddess of the Moon, Lord of Knowledge, something. Passage from Life and Death. Skilled Warrior and Father of the Elven Races. Oversees the interactions of sentient mortals and the other natural world. And the God of the Sun and Time. I'll go with Tempest. I'll be from... Yeah, I'll be from Neverwinter. It's home to a hardy and creative people who have rebuilt their city in the wake of the eruption of Mount Huntanau. While still a shadow of its former glory, the city shows why it is called the City of Skilled Hands. I'll be a militia defender. You have helped defend Neverwinter against the many threats who seek to destroy it. Character name, Mayfor Lager. Yes, and no, this isn't my real name, just so you know. This is a name I made a long time with my brother when the first time I ever made a real character in D&D, I named it Mayfor Lager. This has been kind of a staple with me, along with a bunch of other names like Legend 3454, Legend 4543, Blue Boy 354366, stuff like that. Anyway, begin adventure.
Move around using the WASD keys.
Oh, somebody's talking to me. Is that you, God? Is that you?
Move to Private Wilfred. press F when close to talk to him.
Is that me? Am I talking to myself? I don't know. Look at me. Look at me jump. It's the best game ever. I have to press F.
Thank the gods. When I saw the Dracolich attack the ship, I was afraid there'd be no survivors. What brings you to Neverwinter in such troubled times?
I don't remember, man! Neverwinter is my
Welcome home.
Home,
I think. Not a very auspicious homecoming, is it? Neverwinter is under attack. The necromancer Valyndra is assaulting the city with her undead legions. Search the wreckage along the shore for your gear. It's dangerous to go unarmed right now. When you finish, head up to the camp at the top of the hill. They've got a nice warm fire up there. You'll feel better once you've dried out.
Thank you. Quite
a path leads to your next objective. Press C to toggle it on and off.
Wait, thanks, God.
Here on the map to mark your quest's objective. Press F to interact with characters and objects.
There's a lot of information. Don't fill my head with this nonsense. I got an inferior breastplate. What's this? Adventures reward. Serious package contains items to aid you in your quest. Double click. Open the box. Okay. Oh hey.
Open your inventory. Double click an item to equip it.
Did it.
Press
it.
To toggle mouse cursor and mouse look modes. Quest tracker displays current quest objectives.
Guy is being so helpful. Thank you. Ah, oh, crap, I can't remember the name of my person.
Campfires or rest zones where out of combat players may heal.
I hope this game has a good PvP. Like, I know some games where, like, if you're in a place where you can be attacked. Like, even if you're AFK, people will still try and kill you. I hope this is good kind of like you. You have to accept the PvP request.
It's good to see someone survive the attack on the ship. When you feel ready, please speak to me again.
Yes, let's do it.
Although we stopped Valyndra's main force, the battle is far from over. The battlefield is crawling with mindless undead who lost their masters in the fighting. To make matters worse, the enemy is raising our dead to use against us. Acolyte Naaman is performing a ritual of Kelimvor to lay the newly dead to rest. That is sure to draw an attack here. I must stay and make sure Naaman finishes her ritual. Could you search the battlefield for any wounded we missed and send them here? After you finish with the wounded, go to Del McCourt's camp and tell him our situation.
Let's go.
Let them use sure strike, damaging all foes in front of you. Hover your reticule over objects and enemies to target them.
Hey, got it. I'ma kill you. I love this combat. It's the best combat ever. If you haven't started playing this game, why are you watching this video? You should go watch the movie before playing this game. And if you watch this video, I need the views. But I like the non-turn combat style. Yeah.
Be careful out there!
I will, person. Get off of that guy, daughter.
I need to kick
some zombie butt. Okay, we got two more wounded. I gotta kill everything.
Thanks.
Okay.
guide displays everything you get for leveling up. It may also offer important quests.
Instigator, Destroyer, and Sentinel. Instigator combines the cunning and strength to harness the ferocity of battle to precision attacks and tactical maneuvers. The Destroyer is a torrent of unfettered rage and anger that deals a crushing amount of damage to no foe likely to survive. The Sentinel uses innate strength to entice and regret the aggression of monsters and mitigate blows that would otherwise devastate allies. Companions. Character. Please tell me who I'm aligned with. Please tell me my god. So I can bang him. I can't remember my god. I'm of Neverwinter. I'll put something else later. Oh well. Hello.
We were lucky to drag Valindra's forces back. Thank you for aiding the wounded. They wouldn't have survived much longer with all the undead roving about. I'll try to get medical supplies and reinforcements to Linkletter as soon as possible. Unfortunately, we've got problems of our own here. I'm afraid I have a gruesome task for you. We've driven Valindra's main army off, but our Red Wizard allies are still harassing us with summoned undead. Private Hothidon is trying to drive them off with his archers, but they're short on ammo. Search the battlefield and scavenge some arrows from the corpses. And take them to Hothidon.
No corpse? Oh. Corpse? Oh. Look at my sword. It goes boing. Corpse. Alright, this way. This way? Why am I going back here? What? Oh, other way.
Hold the right mouse button to charge Reaping Strike for extra damage.
Look at me, hands in the air, that's good to be all I don't know. I don't know that song. Hello? Can I kill you? Probably wouldn't be my best idea, actually. Here I come, Mr. Fairy Universe. Good thing these things aren't auto-abs though, or else I'd probably be screwed. Respawn point unlocked. Hothidon, here you go.
You found some ammunition! Excellent. Please place the arrows in one of the barrels. We must drive the wizards back!
You're welcome.
Thank you for the help. The Red Wizards haven't been driven away, but this will at least force them to keep their head.
Level 3.
More undead are attacking Neverwinter. They're boiling out of Castle Never and storming the Sleeping Dragon Bridge. If the bridge falls, they will enter the heart of the city, Protector's Enclave.
I must stay and deal with the Red Wizards. Please, go to the bridge and aid the defenders. Destroy the undead soldiers near the gate to our north so it may be opened safely. Then talk to Private Wilfred. He will get you inside the city and show you the way to the bridge. Be careful, these undead are more aggressive than others you fought. Tempest grant you strength.
Let's see. Use a fast moving slice to lessen the enemies around you briefly, slow them. Okay. But I think I'm gonna be done recording, because my frames are all going to hell. Anyway, this is actually a pretty good game. I'm actually looking forward to playing this some more. If you want to play it for yourself, link to it will be in the description. And until then, I have been Legendary 454. This was Netherwinter. See you guys later.